There is a barbecue that happens in a suburban house in Melbourne, in contemporary Melbourne. It is the house that belongs to Aisha and Hector. Aisha is an Indian Australian, Hector is a Greek Australian. They host this party for friends and family. And at this barbecue, a three-year-old child who is very bratty, very out of control, very undisciplined, is slapped by another man who is not his parent, who is not a relative. That's the incident that begins that novel. I wanted to write a book that was about middle-class Australian suburban culture. I wanted to write because the novel previous to that had been called Dead Europe, which I see as my exorcism of Europe. You know, it was a very difficult novel. It took a long time. And I came away from it thinking, well, this is the place I belong to. It's this place called Australia. I get frustrated because I don't see that place that I belong to reflected in the literature I'm reading, in the films I'm seeing. This is a very diverse city where most of us come from a variety of heritages, whereas the screen and the pages of Australian literature was reflecting a very different kind of reality. So that was the impetus for writing The Slap. And at the same time, there was another thing I wanted to understand, was how in this, and we're talking about the period around 2000, just after that, how was it that this country was becoming one of the richest on the planet and was also becoming one of the meanest and most greed, you know? And I wanted to understand that. My mother and father hosted a barbecue, and you know, it was a very joyous occasion, friends and family, but in the middle of it, this young child, a delightful little boy, was really acting up and being bratty, being undisciplined, being out of control. And my mother gave him this slight tap on his bum, and he just stood in front of her and said, "No one has the right to touch my body without my permission." And you know, it was one of those moments in the interaction between that child and my mother. In one of those moments, in the look, that's how I've talked, that I talk about it, where all that history I wanted to talk about, all that cultural change that I wanted to refer to, all that complicated significance of what it means to be an urban social person at the turn of the millennial, all of that was between the astonished, uncomprehending gaze between my mother and that boy. And I went home that night and started writing The Slap. As a writer, I was working part-time in a veterinary clinic. I was with people I adored, with work that was fascinating for me because it, you know, I was using my hands, I was involved in a very intimate and peculiar relationship between humans and animals that was fascinating and humbling in lots of ways. I had a really good life. I have a, you know, but I didn't. I thought that my role as a writer was within a certain space, and then what happened with The Slap completely changed that. There are accidents in life, and I am incredibly I feel incredibly fortunate for the success, but I just don't think you can plan that. I think you would drive yourself mad if you thought that was something that you couldn't plan. I was very, very fortunate with the Australian adaptation that the people who, the directors, the producers, the writers, some of them were actually people I knew, they were friends of mine, they were people I absolutely trusted with the material. We had a wonderful working period of 3 weeks where I was in the room with the writers and the directors, and they tore up the novel and put it back together again, asked me what felt like 10,000 questions. I got animated, I got excited about it being translated into another medium. But in that translation, I also realised that I was going to walk away because I had written the book. I didn't want to rewrite it. And that trust, and that, you know, I think that trust was absolutely worth it. It paid off because I'm very proud of the Australian miniseries.